into the mic.
Okay. I was wondering if it was okay if I did a quick little video recording for my girlfriend. Would that be okay?
We're basically just doing selfies now. Do you need them to dance or do anything wacky in this video?
Could you say, you're an amazing person, Tess Supernova, and...
It has to be 6 seconds, though. This is for Vine.
Got it.
In your Steven voice or in your Connie voice, could you say that you're an amazing person, Tess, your Starshine loves you?
But wait a second. They don't really know you, so they could be lying. We don't know if you, like... our serial killer.
What if she like doesn't like puppies
or
something?
She's the ruby to my sapphire.
Oh, that says everything.
Oh, this is your friend. Okay. There you go. That was a nice thing to say.
What are we saying?
About your friend.
You're an amazing person, Tess, and your Starshine loves you.
Okay, cool.
Oh, actually, you're an amazing person,
Supernova. This is like a lot of work you're giving them. They normally get paid for this stuff. I don't know if you know this.
I'm so sorry.
Supernova is her name?
It's her nickname. She's Supernova, and I'm Starshine. It's a silly little thing.
Cool.
So you're an amazing person, Supernova. Your Starshine loves you.
Got
There's
it.
The script.
Thank you. Go for it.
All right. Do you want to go first? Let's do it at the same time.
Oh, same time? Okay.
Yeah.
You're an amazing person, Supernova. Your Starshine loves you.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much.
Okay, you owe them 10 grand each. So have a nice day. Move along. All right, next. Oh my God, this is adorable.
Never change.
Never get any larger. That would be probably a problem if that were. There you go.
I just want to ask, how did he come up with the show Steven Universe?
Well, actually, it was created by a very, very talented person named Rebecca Sugar. We adore her for a reason.
She's absolutely amazing, and I love her.
And the most humble person I've ever met in my life.
Definitely, definitely.
We created our voices.
Yes, we did that.
I created the Steven voice with my coach, Tony, in a studio. I got a picture of Steven. I got some lines to say as Steven, and the original song from the extended theme. And we did that, and I sent it in as an audition, and that's how Steven was born.
You guys are so nice, because I would have taken credit for the whole thing. I would have been like, yeah, that was me. Creator, writer, do all the voices. It's just the little thing I do.
That becomes a problem when somebody asks me to draw the characters. Because I can't draw a stick figure.
Oh, less. Man. Well, that was a good question. Thank you. Oh, he's so cute. There we go. All right.
I have two questions, one for Zach and the other one for both of you. First, do you think Steven will ever be able to fuse with the crystal gems?
That is more of a Rebecca question.
Will Steven be able to fuse with the crystal gems?
I might know the answer, but I'm not allowed to say anything.
Okay.
Because...
No spoilers, okay?
Spoilers are strictly forbidden by the cartoon code.
And a second question, what is your favorite episode?
Favorite episode. One of my personal favorite episodes is actually Keep Beach City Weird, because I absolutely love the Fribo family. And I don't know if any of you guys know that the Keep Beach City Weird is actually an actual Tumblr, and it's an amazing place to just look at funny things that Ronaldo says, and it's in character and amazing.
Ronaldo is one of my favorite side characters, no doubt about it.
Definitely.
No calling out before it's your turn.
Rare.  Pronaldo.
Pronaldo?
Pronaldo?
Is that what that ship is called? I don't keep up with what the kids are doing.
All right, well, thank you for the question.
My favorite episode is Steven and the Stevens, by the way. Because there were four Stevens, and I had to voice all of them, and it was a bit of a crazy mess, but we had a good time.
Nice outfit, by the way, and you have the natural hair. Both of you turn around towards the crowd. Look at this. One of these is fake. I'm not going to say which. I don't want to give it up, but thank you very much. See you later. Next. Oh, wait, before you ask your question, I just want to tell everyone, you guys... Today's Zach's birthday!
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Zach! And it's a big one, too. You guys, he's 18 today. Pretty awesome. He's an adult today. Yeah, settle down, ladies. He's an adult. Okay, next.
My name's Brianna, and I was just wondering what the hardest scene or song was to record for the show.
As far as songs go, Strong in the Real Way and Giant Woman both pushed my vocal range quite a bit. Because that second time I say Giant Woman, all I want to do is see you turn into a giant woman. A giant woman! It's way up there. That took me to the very edge. But it all turned out okay, and it was fun to do. But those were very challenging. The songs, honestly, are the hardest part of Steven Universe for me, because singing in a character voice is so much different than just speaking in it. And it requires a lot of extra effort.
Yeah. For me, it was definitely a challenge to record Do It For Her, because my natural voice is a lot lower. And as Zach was saying, singing in the voice of Connie is an entirely different beast than speaking as Connie. And so it was a fun challenge to record that. And as far as speaking goes, it was when I recorded Open Book and I had to play Evil Connie and Real Connie, that was extremely challenging because I had to switch back and forth, and it was the same voice but an entirely different personality, and just thinking behind it was different. But that was extremely challenging, but also very fun, and fun to listen back to.
And doing voiceover is so much more than just doing a funny voice. So like you were saying, Zach, that you had a coach help you create the character.
Right.
So explain what that was like.
Well, I still work with my coach every now and then, just because you can never stop learning. And especially in something as deep and as difficult at times as voice acting. But working with a coach, I mean, he was there almost since the very beginning of when I did voiceover, and taught me the basic stuff, how to stand in front of a mic, how to mic technique, things like that, from inflection and emotion. And I mean, he covered it all with me. Tony G, shout out. Definitely helped me a lot and was instrumental in creating the Steven we have today.
Right. So much more than just doing a funny sounding voice, you're acting.
Right.
Definitely. I think a lot of people think that voiceover is just standing and reading a bunch of lines on a piece of paper, but there's actually a lot more that goes into it. You really have to get into the character, and it really is its own art.
Moving and making facial expressions is something I think all of us do in the booth.
Definitely.
I mean, you can't stand there and look monotone while doing this completely non-monotone voice. You have to emote and move with it to make it sound right. And even though it may not sound different to your ear, if you say a line normally and then you say it while smiling, it may sound the same to you, but it makes a world of a difference to everybody else.
It really brings it to life.
And it can be hard to critique yourself sometimes because you don't get the full sound of your own voice, and that makes it all the more difficult.
Yeah, for sure. A lot goes into it. Hello.
Hi, I'm Nicole.
Hello.
So I have two things. First is for both. Do you think Connie will have a role in the cluster?
I'm afraid I cannot answer that. I'm sorry.
Okay, my second thing, I moved here from North Carolina, and I left all my friends behind, and they really wanted to come to this. And so I was wondering if you can do a video saying hi to each of them.
Oh, for crying out loud!
Their names is Rose Tia Giera. Rose Tia Giera.
What if they said no? That'd be hilarious to me. I'll get out of the video.
Okay, one, two, three.
Hi, Rose.
Hi, Rose.
Hi, Tia.
Hey, Tia.
Hi, Gia.
Hi, Gia.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
No problem.
You guys are so nice. Aren't they nice? Jeez.
Extremely.
I would have been like, nah, I'm not doing it. No, I wouldn't have done that. Hi, what's your name?
I'm Anais, and this is for Zach. Do you want lions as a pet?
In real life?
Yes.
I think so. I'd probably regret that later, but... Yeah, I'll say yeah. I love my dog. I feel like they'd get along very well because they're both very mellow. But Lion is a bit of a buffoon sometimes. But I'd say yeah.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. What's your name?
I am King Pumpkin.
King Pumpkin.
Yes. Hello, King
okay.
Pumpkin.
That's weird. Your mom named you that or your dad?
The Skeleton Lord, yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Got it.
That's pretty spooky.
Yeah.
Okay.
I actually wanted to ask, like you... how you do with fans. Is there ever a point in, like, with your family where you have to hide things from them, like, about the show, where they ask and you're like, hey, sorry, I can't say anything?
I mean, my parents, I usually share it with them because I know that they're not going to tell anybody.
They're not going to blog or tweet about it.
Right. But yeah, once it...
Like, Zach's grandma's Twitter is huge, though. Like, she's got so
many spoilers on there. Don't go on there if you care about watching the show.
No, yeah, I don't hide the show plot lines from my parents. They're pretty involved.
True. Okay, thank you.
No problem.
Bye. Get out of here! All right, next. Hi, what's your name?
Michael.
Hi, Michael.
Okay, so you don't mind if I'm doing, like, too many questions, right?
We do, because it's a long line. But how about we go 2 questions?
Okay. That doesn't count as a question, by the way. Okay.
Sorry, you're down 1. Let's go.
That was your
last question.
Okay, so how did you guys get into voice acting?
I actually booked a radio show that maybe one person in here might be familiar with called Adventures in Odyssey.
That too.
You did Adventure Nuts?
Yeah.
Yeah, I played Matthew Parker for like 5 years.
How did I get booked on this show? Because it sounds like a good show to get booked on.
It was so long ago.
Oh, man. Yeah, the show's been on for 25 years, but it was one of my first VO auditions, and it kind of catapulted me.
How old were you?
I was 11.
Wow.
And I've always been a film actor. That's how I started, theater actor. Yeah. And that kind of pushed me into voiceover. And I did a couple things after that, Scooby-Doo episodes, some... DC Comics shorts, Captain Marvel, now Shazam. And that brought me to Steven Universe eventually.
And do you find that one job like that just leads to another one?
Yeah, it's experience. And once you get in-studio experience, you learn how things work, what works better for you, and it helps you book more, I think.
Okay. Definitely. I started acting, on camera acting, when I was about 4 years old, and I was very precocious, and I was very talkative, and eventually I got sent out on a voiceover audition because I had this very bright, clear voice that I loved enunciating, so all of the voiceover casting directors was like, oh, perfect. She can read. So that's,
you have to be able to read to do voiceover. We don't memorize our lines. We're a little lazy.
Yeah, but one thing led to another, and here I am, the voice of Connie.
So, do you have any tips for future voice actors out there? Like,
start when you're 4. So, sorry, you're already too old.
You got a time machine, kid? Fantastic. I would say, I mean, it's a what you have to do is understand that it is a game of time, and you have to put in a ton of time to get any results, and you won't get results in the beginning. That's the kind of sucky truth is that...
I mean, that's for everything on the internet, to
right,
be honest.
Right. Once you start, you have to train before you'll see any results. Very few people make it overnight or find success instantly on that first or second audition. It's a numbers game, and you have to play it for a long time to get it to work out in your favor.
Definitely. And adding on top of that, I definitely think you have to have a thick skin because rejection is just part of the process. You can go for a year or two. I know before I booked Connie, I was auditioning for about 2 years and I hadn't gotten anything. So you just have to keep pushing through it and eventually you hit your stride. But if you give up, then you never know what you might achieve.
I mean, that's what they always say for on-camera acting too, that you need a thick skin. And I cry every day, so that's why I'm a stand-up comedian, and that's all that I'm qualified for. The same thing with on-camera acting too, though, with what you were saying, the training is a big part of it. So thank you. Nice questions, Michael. See you later,
right,
buddy.
On voice acting, you guys are amazing.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Hi, what's your name?
I'm Gwen.
Hello.
Hi. It's kind of a silly question, but I just wanted to question... What are your favorite gems, the gems in general?
That is not a silly question.
It's okay. Besides Steven, somebody said I always answer this question. Besides Steven, it's probably Peridot.
That's my gemstone.
Everybody's favorite space Dorito. I love the character, and Shelby Rabara is the nicest, most bubbly, most talented person to work with, and she's so funny. It just makes Peridot come to life, and it's I feel like when I answer that question, I'm excluding the other gems, but Peridot's kind of new on my radar, so it's very interesting to work around.
Okay.
How could I ever choose? I have to say Garnet is my favorite. I definitely love Garnet. I love her one-liners. And how could you not love a pair of lesbian space rocks?
Yes! Great, great question.
And as a follow-up, my favorite is Jem and the Hologram. So a little older than some of you guys. Okay.
Good, so, good answer.
Thank you very much.
We actually had a hologram, so you're not completely off the mark there.
There you go. I know what I'm talking about. Hello, what's your name?
Madison. I just wanted to ask, out of the three gems, which one would you want as a sister in real life for Zach?
Oh, man. Pearl would nag. probably Amethyst to be the fun sister, get into trouble and stuff. Garnet is a close second.
Yeah, I'm an only child, so I'm just thinking very hypothetically here right now. I definitely would love to get up to some shenanigans with Amethyst. We would be rabble-rousers together, for sure.
Chili tip!
Thank you.
Hi, what's your name?
Denna. By the way, I love you both so much.
Thank you. We love you too.
Two questions. One for both of you. Oh, first one for you, sorry. Could you do, like, Steve? Wait. I'm so sorry.
Can I do Steven?
Fangirl.
Could you do Steven doing an impression of Peridot?
Yes. Okay, I think I got this. Let's try it. I don't know how this is going to sound. Ew, Clutch!
Second question. How jealous do you think Lapis would be of Connie?
Ooh.
That's
interesting.
A really good question.
How jealous Lapis would be of Connie?
Connie and Steven's friendship.
I definitely would be jealous that I was not underneath the ocean, but I definitely think Connie and Steven have a really pure and strong bond, and I do think that given Lapis's circumstances, she would be pretty sad that she couldn't develop a sort of thing, a sort of bond with Steven just based on her limitations currently, to say the least.
Under the sea. I'm sorry, Lavis. That was very cruel.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Problem. Hi, what's your name?
I'm Jennifer. Happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you.
When you guys first got any mention of Stefani, what were your first thoughts? Like, how did you guys feel when you got the fusion of Connie and Steven?
I had not been informed ahead of time that we were doing it, because certain plot points Rebecca informs me about, but I don't think I knew about that one before I got the script. I was like, okay, that's possible. Cool, let's do it. And I didn't know who they were going to get to play it, but I mean, AJ Michalka, so much fun to work with. And we have a story about it. We had to teach her how to do both of our laughs,
yeah.
And she combined them beautifully.
It was so cool. So first, Zach did his signature Steven laugh, and then I did my signature Connie laugh, and AJ did a wonderful job of just finding a way to fuse them together. And it was so cool. And also, when I found out that AJ Michalka was voicing Stefani, I had a little freak out because Allie and AJ was my first concert, so that was awesome.
We've had some really cool people on our show,
yeah.
And it sucks because I don't get to meet a lot of them. I never met Nicki Minaj or Sinbad, but it's cool that we're working with those people.
Technically.
IMDb says we are, so.
Yeah. That's all
Thank
that matters.
You. Hi, what's your name?
I am Harleen.
Hi. Hello, Harleen.
By the way, happy birthday, Zach.
Thank you.
There's two people that I want you to say happy birthday to as well for this month.
Okay.
They were not able to come. They're my two sisters, Catherine and Daisy. So if you guys wouldn't mind, can you please say or sing happy birthday in your Connie and Steven voices for me?
Yeah.
Just say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Or give a long line. There's
Yeah.
There's a guy on the end of the line everybody. That's like, come on, what is this, Space Mountain on the end of this thing?
All right. Whenever you're ready.
You guys.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, you guys! Happy birthday to us!
Thank you guys so much.
Of course.
Oh my gosh, thanks.
You're welcome. Hi, what's your name?
I'm Melanie.
Hello.
Hi. I was just kind of wondering what it felt like for you guys as actors when, because I'm assuming, you know, when you audition, you never know, like, the emotional and characterization that, you know, a short format cartoon kind of ended up taking. So, like, what was that process like? Because I'm guessing you guys were probably only about 6 episodes ahead or so of what comes out on TV. Like, they turn them over pretty quick, it seems.
We're actually about 30 or something.
Yeah, we're very ahead. Yeah,
it's like 9 months between our records and air, which means that we are way ahead of the storyline, but it's kind of fun to see it
all
unfold.
Does that mean you record first? Do they animate to your voices?
Yes.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, we recorded the storyboards, and then they make it into an animatic, send it off to Korea. They animate it there. Super talented team over there, and then they send it back for post.
So there's storyboards, so you know basically what it's going to look like.
Yeah.
You read the scripts in your voices, obviously, and then they animate it from there.
Sometimes when I'm really tired, I read it in my normal voice to see what it sounds like.
And see how they animate it.
Yeah, just my really gravelly morning voice.
Yes. And you guys, just so you know, they just completed season 2 and they did get picked up for season 3.
Yay!
More Steven!
Congratulations.
Yeah, how does it feel getting that like emotional kind of content in like a short format cartoon? Like, was that unexpected or like...
It's amazing. I watch the show in my free time, and I have cried watching the show, like I'm sure many fans have. It is an emotional roller coaster, and it is shocking how much you can laugh and cry in 11 minutes. But just knowing that I'm a part of it is amazing. It's so beautiful knowing that I get to be a part of Steven Universe.
The thing I like to think about is when we were doing the whole Ruby and Sapphire storyline, and like in Sadie's song when Steven's in a dress, those things didn't stand out to me when we were doing them. They were just kind of normal. It was, we're doing the episode. But when they came out and the impact they had on the community really blew me away. And I didn't think that it was possible for a cartoon to have that kind of impact and that kind of positive force behind it, but Rebecca Sugar works in mysterious ways that affect us
so
all.
So true.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi, what's your name?
Hey, my name is Ryan. Hello. Happy birthday, Zach.
Thanks, man.
I was just going to ask if there's... I had 2 questions, actually. I was going to ask if there's any stories you can give us about maybe behind the scenes, how the making of an episode or how you get into character. If there's any stories you guys had about that, maybe?
I got a funny story. We were doing some, it was pretty early on. I think it might have been the actual Sword Fighter episode. But Dee Dee had to do, she plays Pearl, she had to do a ton of fighting noises.
I know I know the story.
Oh, yeah. Well, we have an engineer over Cartoon Network that we love very much named Robert Serta. And he has this thing sometimes where if you have a weird flub take or you say something when you think he's not rolling, he records it and then he loops it and plays it back at random times throughout the session. So Dee Dee was doing these fighting noises, and one of the last ones she did came out so weird. My interpretation of it, yeah. It was very strange. It's stranger than that. And he just would not stop playing. And every time we would start cracking up, and Dee Dee was like blushing. And it was just really funny how often it got played. I think he played it in the next session one time as well. It just kept going and going and going. But stuff like that happens all the time. There was one time where Michaela Dietz, who plays Amethyst, was talking about this stand-up comedy bit, and I mean, it was this really raunchy bit she was talking about, and she didn't think he was rolling, and then he started playing back the bit over and over and over again, much to her embarrassment. I think we might have had guests that day, too. It was really funny.
That's awesome.
When you guys record, do you record all together in the studio, or do you guys go in separately to do your lines?
One of my favorite things about Steven Universe is that often we do, a group of us records together. Often it'll be me, Zach, Dee Dee, and Michaela, Pearl, and Amethyst. And
sometimes one of us won't be able to be there and we'll have to record separately, but that's no fun because I love recording it with everyone, because that's one thing special about working on this show is that a lot of there's just this, we all get to play off of each other's energy, and it feels a lot more like a family than other things I've worked on.
It's kind of sucky right now because our cast is so fragmented. Dee Dee is doing a Broadway, off-Broadway tour for If Then, the show, for 6 months. I'm not going to see her the whole time. I've missed a couple sessions traveling lately. Estelle and Tom Sharpling live in New York, so we never get to record with them anymore. It's like the big family has left the nest and is separated, but whenever we come together at conventions or rarely when people are in town, it's always a fun reunion, and we love recording together.
That's the magic of voiceover, though. You can, if you're traveling or whatever, you can find a studio somewhere and record your lines, right?
Right, right. I have a briefcase now with a studio in it. I have a microphone, a USB setup. I plug it into my computer. And not only do I do auditions on it, but I can also record, like, impromptu sessions. If somebody really needs something last minute, I can Skype with them and get directed and do it all in like a hotel room with a bunch of pillows behind it.
That's really funny because Grace and I were just talking about that before the panel.
Yeah.
Sometimes you, if you need to, you can do voiceover even at home in a pinch.
Definitely. Yep. I'm actually in college right now in San Francisco, and I can't always get to a studio. And so sometimes what I do is I get a bunch of blankets and put them over my head and record my auditions from my dorm room. And I always wonder, can the people living next door to me hear me yelling and screaming right now? Probably.
And if so, who cares?
Yeah, my dad heard me singing through the walls the other day for an audition. I'm like, oh man, that means everybody's hearing me in this hotel.
Hey, listen, dads have caught their sons doing much worse, so that's nothing. So thank you very much, and we'll keep the line moving. Have a great day. Hi, what's your name?
I'm Nikki.
Hi, Nikki.
You said you work with Rebecca, right?
Well, into the mic so we can hear
sorry.
You.
What is she like?
Or what is Rebecca like?
I don't know what kind of person she is or something.
She's
like
She's a sweetheart.
What if they were like, she is horrible. I cannot take this job anymore.
I cannot work under these conditions.
No, she's absolutely wonderful. I was actually a big fan of her work before I started working on the show. I was a huge fan of her work on Adventure Time. So when I actually got the role of Connie, I started screaming. I was in my home and I was screaming because I loved Rebecca Sugar so much. And so meeting her was a dream, and she's absolutely a lovely person.
I had the opposite experience. I didn't really know what to expect when I met her. All I knew is that when the show got picked up, she was we did the pilot together, but she was Cartoon Network's first female showrunner. But she is so talented and so crazy humble about it. She's very soft-spoken, very very gentle personality, but she's a creative genius, artistic genius. And honestly, I love the way the community kind of idolizes her, because you don't see that, especially with animation, you don't see that with a lot of showrunners, but she absolutely deserves it, and it's cool to see that.
She deserves every word of praise she gets.
And more.
Yes. So yes, she's nice. That's the answer to your question. What were your auditions like?
I actually recorded the audition in my coach's studio. All I got was photo of Steven, or drawing from Rebecca, brief character breakdown, 10 lines, and the lyrics to the theme song, which was the extended theme at the time. And we recorded it together, sent it out, ended up getting a callback, which they brought me to Cartoon Network Studios in Burbank for that. Basically did the same thing, read it all in the studio. They gave me some direction. I think it was down to like 3 people at that point. And then a week later, got a call. You're doing the pilot.
That's an awesome phone call.
Yeah, I actually was thinking about this earlier today, but I remember it was one of my last days of my sophomore year of high school, and after school, my mom drove me to a studio to record my audition, and again, just a few pictures of Connie, some preliminary sketches, and a little blurb about her personality, and I did my best, and I didn't know what to expect, I actually kind of forgot about the audition, because when you in voiceover, you kind of have to have a very go with the flow attitude, because
always looking forward.
Yeah, because so a lot of the time, if you don't hear back, you just didn't get it. So around 2 weeks later, two or 3 weeks later, my mom told me that I got the part, and it was just flooding back to me that how much I really wanted it, and as I said earlier, I started screaming.
Yeah, because when you do an audition, you have to kind of do your best and then kind of forget about it. That's the whole thick skin thing, too.
Definitely.
Yeah, for sure. All right, well, thank you for your question. Next. Yeah, we got a duo.
Hey there.
What's up, guys? What's your names?
This is Isabella, and I'm Lucy.
Okay.
We were wondering if you could do in your Steven Universe voices. Can you say, we love you, Lucy and Isabella?
All right. It's not for somebody else. They're just no shame. All right.
We love you, Lucy and Isabella!
Woo!
Woohoo!
And cut.
And scene.
Thank you so much. Happy birthday, Zach.
Oh, thank
birthday.
You.
Bye, guys. Hi. What's your name?
My name is Sabrina. I have two questions for you. Do you like the way that Rebecca designs the gym's outfits?
No. Oh, that was for them. Just kidding.
It was interesting to see the difference between the pilot and the show's designs, because I think they improved dramatically. Because they look cool in the pilot, but what they've done thus far and some of the changes they made as the show has gone on, they're super cool. But we have an amazing art team that does some cool stuff with the characters.
How many people are on the art team?
I have no idea, actually. It's pretty big. We take up, I think, most of the second floor.
I think we take up almost the entire second floor.
I think we might share a space with regular show.
Okay.
But we have a cereal bar up there, which is cool.
Cartoon Network studios are fun.
Yeah, it's not just one artist. There's a whole team of people working on this.
Oh, yeah. Actually, all the background art is, or not all of it, but a good portion of it is done by Steven Sugar, Rebecca's brother, who...
Oh, wow.
I mean, he's the real Steven. So I got to meet him after a few episodes into the records, and that was kind of surreal.
Oh, fun fact.
Yeah, he kind of looks like what you'd imagine adult Steven to be. He's got the same hair, but he's got a beard now. But he's a really nice guy, just like Rebecca. Their whole family's great. Her parents are super cool, too.
Oh, wow, really cool.
Okay, and my other one, can you imitate your favorite lines from Steven Universe?
Let's see. There's so many good ones. Here's one I haven't done in a while. You've seen Tiger Millionaire, right?
You couldn't afford it!
Let me think of a good Connie line. Let's see. Oh. Okay, this one's from Open Book. It's probably paraphrased a little bit, but here goes.
Oh, Steven, of course you love the cake. You love schmaltz.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
Hi, what's Hello. Your name?
Asia.
Hi.
I also have two questions. Who's your favorite fusion?
Sardonyx.
Yes.
I love Sardonyx.
Sardonyx is very cool. Well, I feel like I kind of have to say it's Devani.
Now I feel bad. I forget that my character fuses sometimes. I was so enthralled by the voice and the design of Sardonyx and the whole shtick of the television host presenter. I thought it was so cool and so unexpected.
Yeah, definitely. Sardonyx is a close second.
My other question is, tell Rebecca Sugar hello.
Will do. Hello from Asia. Not the continent, the person.
Bye, thank you.
Of course.
Hi, Zach.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Pretty good, I know you.
I know you too. And hey, guys.
What's your
name?
You
want to help me embarrass Zach? It's his birthday today. So we're all going to sing happy birthday. Like right now, okay?
Let's
Can somebody
it.
Get this on camera? Anybody?
I think my dad's already on it.
Awesome, he's already on it. All right, ready? On a count of three. Everybody in the room, sing happy birthday to Zach, okay? One, two, three. three. Happy birthday to you. Louder!
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Zach. Happy birthday to you. Woo!
You're looking at me so smug, like, oh, I got you.
I totes got you. Happy birthday, love. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hi.
Hello. Hi. And what's your name?
Amethyst, obviously.
Hello, Amethyst.
Great cosplay, by the way.
Thank you. Actually, I was actually super mad that this girl came out because I was going to have everybody sing happy birthday. I don't know who you are, but I'm going to go find you after this.
Go get
I'm
going
to have a long talk, like angry
you
talk.
You can find her right over there at her table.
This is a no-bullying.
Thank you so much. I'm going to go over there right now and have like a fist fight with her.
A stern talk
I like
to
how
you.
My question is, I'm going to kill that girl. Good question. Okay.
I'm asking for permission. But yeah, I don't have an actual question, so.
All right.
Happy
well.
Birthday.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
Do you have the whip?
I do have the whip. My sister has the
all
whip.
All right, you will win that fight then. Go get it.
I will.
There it is.
Go right now. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Hello. What does your shirt say?
My shirt says, I'm not lazy. I just enjoy doing nothing.
I'm not lazy. I just
fantastic.
Really enjoy doing nothing.
I agree with that statement.
It's your passion in life.
I'm Nathan.
Hi, Nathan.
I have two questions for you. One, do you ever think you'll be able to write your own episode of Steven Universe?
Oh, God.
I don't know if I want to try. That's so much pressure.
I would screw it up horrendously. And I write sometimes, but I there's no way I could touch the level of genius that everybody has over there. Like I feel like I'd be committing sacrilege or something.
Definitely. Sometimes when I'm just reading the scripts before I go in, I'm just laughing and just staring in awe at the proficiency and excellence of all of the writers that we have on our team. On our Steven Crooniverse.
Steven Crooniverse.
Yeah, because it takes a whole team of people. I mean, you guys, you're experts at voiceover, and that takes up all your time and energy, and it's not like you can just go, hey, I'm just going to write a script now, too. And also, the writers aren't going to start doing voice acting. So it takes that whole team.
That's not true, actually.
Okay, maybe one or two of them. Really, which writer does voice acting?
I know Lamar, I don't think he's a writer, but he does Sour Cream. And sometimes we have them in for crowd walla, like when we need people to do the crowds of Beach City, everybody in the booth hops in. So Ben and Matt and Ian, they'll get in and help
so
us out.
So forget everything I just said, guys. Wow, that's awesome.
Obviously, you're an expert.
Yeah, that's why I'm wearing a hat. Anytime someone wears a hat, they're automatically an expert.
It conveys authority.
That's right.
This is true.
What's your other question?
My second question is, what's your favorite song on Steven Universe?
It's not even my song, but it's so cliche. It's Stronger Than You.
It's my favorite song, too, and it is cliche, but it's so good.
Jailbreak is just one of our best episodes, I think, honestly.
I actually got to see a preview of the song before it aired. Rebecca took me to her office. She was like, you got to see this. And I was like, oh, my God, I wanted to air so badly. And I'm actually in the dark about a lot of things that Connie isn't personally involved in. So that was one of the only times where Rebecca actually like showed me something that was going to
let
happen.
Let you in but, behind
yeah,
the curtain.
Exactly.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Zach.
Thank you, man.
He's back.
Hello
again. I just want to ask, why did you create a show called Steven Universe?
Why did you create a show called Steven Universe?
Why did you name it after yourself? God.
It's very self-centered, I know. I'm a very vain person. I think Steven Universe as a title is way better than Steven's Universe, as some people call it. Because I didn't realize for a while that his name was actually Steven Universe. Like, we were like two episodes in, and I think Greg calls him Steven Universe, and he's referred to as Greg Universe. I asked Rebecca, is Universe his last name? She's like, yeah. You didn't know that? I was like, yeah, I knew that. I was just double checking.
Yeah.
Steven Universe.
Why did you create this show?
it was a long thought out process. I had a lot of different ideas, but ultimately I just thought it was the best one.
All right.
TLDR rocks.
Happy birthday, Jack.
Thanks, buddy. Hey, guys.
So Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
My name is Kathy. Oh, okay. By the way, I love your guys' outfits. Really cute fashion sense.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I dressed myself.
I have one question for both of you guys. What is one episode that you guys are very emotionally you guys can relate to, or an episode recently that you guys can relate?
There have been times, I can't specifically recall which episodes, but there have been times where Steven has to get very, very upset, and it, by proxy, it makes me very, very upset. It brings you to the verge of tears when you have to play being at the verge of tears. And that happens surprisingly often for an 11-minute cartoon. But it's always a privilege when we have an episode that does have that hefty, emotional thing going on. I can't remember the name of the episode. It's the one with Lil Butler. It's the fireworks one.
Capacity.
What is it?
Maximum capacity.
Thank you. Got my wiki over there. That one, I know Steven gets very, very upset with his father for basically ditching him to watch Lil Butler with Amethyst. And that was a really poignant moment for Steven, I think. And it was definitely tough to play, but it's stuff like that that really makes me love the show even more.
Mm-hmm. I think that kind of stuff's tough for good actors, though.
Yeah.
You know, you guys are good actors. When you're really, for real, feeling those emotions that you're trying to put into the character instead of just playing it on the surface, you know, that's when you're really feeling sad about something or emotional about something.
Getting out of character is just as important as getting into character.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you're in that state, you
have to. So that you're just not a crazy person walking around the streets of L.A., right?
Yeah,
you have to be able to snap out of it.
Crying my eyes out all the time.
Oh, like me.
Life of a comic.
And then you're like, oh, I'm playing Lisa Correa. Nice.
I'd say for me, this is a tough one, but I definitely think Connie's first appearance, Bubble Buddies, has a very special place in my heart. Because of acting, I was actually homeschooled for a really long time in the early half of my life. I was homeschooled from kindergarten up through eighth grade, and then I went to a real school for ninth grade. But when I was recording it, I really related to a lot of Connie's just like insecurity in a lot of ways about how to really be friends with people, because I didn't have that much firsthand experience growing up. I had friends, but I definitely didn't have the normal socialization experience. And when I actually recorded Bubble Buddies, it was a little bit emotional for me.
All right, thank you guys so much. I hope you guys have a good day here at Animate Miami, and happy birthday, Zach.
Thank you.
Thank you. And if you guys are taking pictures and tweeting them, make sure you do hashtag Animate Miami, and they'll show up on the screen up here. Hi, what's your name?
Hello, I'm Static Shock, but you could call me
nice.
Matthew.
Superhero Static Shock.
My question is, in the episode of Mirror Gem, where Lapis Gem got repaired, she flew away to, we're going to assume homeworld. And I'm just wondering, can gems breathe through space since her bodies are just like rocks and mass?
You know, I don't know for sure, but as far as I know, yes. But don't quote me on that. That's again, that's a Rebecca question if you ever get the chance. But yeah, that thing is a mind of its own. Yeah, I mean, they can breathe underwater, so I don't see why they couldn't breathe in space. But they don't need to eat or anything like that, because they're not human.
They don't have human bodily needs, so.
Right. Technically, they don't have a body at all. It's just their gem, and the body is a projection. But.
Okay, I have one more question. Out of all the powers you've seen through the gems, which one would each of you would want?
Not future vision.
No.
I have enough anxiety as it is.
Amethyst makes shapeshifting look really fun.
That would be my pick, I think.
Yeah.
For sure.
All right. Thank you, and happy birthday.
Thanks, man.
All right. Thank you. Hi, what's your name?
My name's Arian.
Hey.
And I just want to say I love the content you guys put out with the show Steven Universe.
Thank you.
I have one request, just little background information. I just came here for high school from an American school in India, and I had a really good best friend there, and she fell in love with the show when I introduced it with her. And I just wanted to see, oh God, I just wanted to see if you could just say like, hi Betty, this is Steven, this is Connie, and we're saying hi from Animate Miami for her.
Betty? Is it Betty?
Betty?
Yeah, Betty.
Cool.
All right.
Let me get it ready. Okay. Ready?
Hey Betty, it's Steven from Animate Miami!
Hey Betty, it's Connie from Animate Miami!
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Hey Betty, you don't know me, hi.
Thank you so much.
Of course.
Thanks.
Hi, my name is Natalie.
Hi Natalie.
My first question is, which one is your favorite homeworld gem?
Peridot, because Doritos.
Peridot is my favorite homeworld gem as well.
And my second question is, how do you feel about Onion?
Onion is the best character on the show. Better than Steven.
Onion.
For sure.
What can one say about Onion? What can one say about one that does not talk at all?
A fun fact, whenever Onion has to vocalize or do anything like that, that's me. Whenever he does his little, I do all that. And I take great pride in it.
There you go.
And sometimes when people ask what I do on Steven Universe, I say I play Onion.
Claim to fame.
Awesome. Thank you, Natalie.
Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
I'm Lockwood.
Hello.
Hey.
Hi. I have a request and a question. Everybody I've asked thinks this is a terrible idea, but I want a Steven Universe and Silent Hill crossover. Everybody, what's your opinion on that?
I love crossovers, and I'm not so great with scary things, but
that's a shame.
I think it would be fun to do.
Okay, and my request is, can you say in Steven's voice, fatality?
Fatality!
Thank you.
All right.
Finish him.
Hi, I'm Rebecca.
Hey, Rebecca.
Are you going to ever make a Steven Universe movie?
If they let us, I'm in, yeah.
Thanks.
No opposition here.
Hi, I'm Nicole. Do you think if Steven were to be watching the show Steven Universe, do you think he would try to create a gem Sona despite the fact that he himself is a gem?
So the Steven watching Steven Universe, is he a gem or is he a normal person named Steven?
Can you answer for both?
He would definitely create a gem Sona. I think if he didn't have a gem, he would definitely create one. But if he did have his gem, I think he would make a gem Sona based on himself that's like an exaggerated version of all his powers.
Yeah, so he would have like a super shield and...
Yeah, that reminds me. I need to create a gem Sona, I feel like. I've never done it.
I should too.
I also have a second question. How do you feel about the theories that Onion is possibly on the autistic spectrum?
I have never heard that, actually.
Oh.
I wouldn't be the person to ask. It's not impossible, I guess, but I've never actually heard that theory before.
That's the first time I've heard that theory too, as well. Yeah, that it wouldn't surprise me.
But. For now, he's just Onion. Onion is a state of being.
But was he vaccinated or not? I think that's the... No? Not, just one person? Okay.
Anyway, happy
good
birthday.
Good questions. Thanks.
Hi. As Lapis Lazuli, how's the search for me going?
Pretty dandy.
You look amazing, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
To show the audience,
so
look at
well
this.
Done.
Wow.
What a cosplay.
Great cosplay.
Lapis and Amethyst are some of the hardest cosplays to do because of the body paint, so kudos to you.
Thank you. Also, can I get a selfie with you guys?
Sure.
Sure. All
right.
Ooh. Here, do it right here.
Okay.
Hop in there.
Yeah.
That's a video.
Oh.
What's
wait,
up?
Is this moving?
It's a video.
Oh,
she
hey
she got us
there
on video. She pulled the old fast trick on us.
Hello, you don't know me either. Bye, thank you. Oh no, what's in the bag?
Comic books.
Okay.
Comic
good
books. What
I
else
thought you
in a
were
Comic-Con?
Like bringing it up. Like I baked you a cake, no?
No cakes there, just comic books. So all right. Robin.
What's your name?
My name is Aries. I just had a question regarding the if you guys think would
Steven Universe would have developed differently if it would have been an adult show rather than a cartoon show?
Absolutely. I mean, depends on what kind of adult show, because if it was like an Adult Swim type show, it would be much more comedy heavy, but if it were like...
Like how adult? Like Cinemax After Dark or like...
The other direction I was thinking is much more, much closer to what we are as an anime focused at adults. Because our show is so anime inspired. Every Definitely. Single person on the team is a huge anime buff for the most part. And there's lots of little references slipped in there.
Homages.
So.
Has there been several scenes that have been removed due to restrictions from Cartoon Network?
Scenes, no. Certain lines of dialogue have been changed.
Sometimes we'll have alt recordings, just alternative lines that we also record just in case the network is like, no, you can't say that.
Specifically, it's S&P, Standards and Practices at Cartoon Network. We'll shoot down certain things. And it's usually a word that doesn't seem like it would be a problem, because there's certain words we get away with that are like, that's kind of dirty for American television. But it's the inconspicuous ones that get you because it mean different things internationally. And you never know what...
Like what, for example?
I can't even think of an example right now. It's been so long since that's come up, but like you never know what significance the word, like something silly like stinker or pants has in another country. And they have to work around that.
All right. Well, thank you very much and have a nice day. Happy birthday, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks.
Pearl.
Hi, happy birthday.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Pearl. Okay, so I have two questions. The first one is, like, was there any episode where everything just went crazy? Like, everything went wrong, and it was just really chaotic?
I wouldn't say it all went wrong, because I had a great time doing it. Stevens and the Stevens, which is my favorite episode, partially because of this. That was my most fast-paced session we've ever done, because I had to do Steven times 4 and times 100 in the last scene. And we literally stretched, like, just Steven all 4 hours of our session. Usually we're done in 2.5, 3, and they have time to record other actors. But, I mean, it was fast-paced, one block of trying to get this entire episode done. We had 3 songs. Somehow, we managed to get all of it done and stay on schedule.
Mm. Okay, and my second question, do you guys have any personal ships? Like, other than canon ships, do you guys ship any of the characters?
See, you foiled me there, because usually I just say Rose and Greg and get on with it. But that's canon. No, I can't really, in good conscience, pair anyone off, because I don't know. It just feels weird to mess with the framework of things for me. I'm not a big fan fiction writer for my own.
No, yeah. I definitely think all of the canon ships are very close to my heart, so it's hard for me to imagine the characters that are paired off with other characters.
All right, thank you.
Thanks. Hi, what's your name? We're going to do just one question each because we're down to the last 5 minutes.
Hi, guys. My name is Lena, and Pearl stole my question. I was going to ask you guys what your favorite ship was, but it's too late for that.
My favorite ship is the Titanic.
Happy birthday, Zach. Bye.
Thank you.
Hi, Zach. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I don't know you remember me since you went to Magic City last year.
Magic City, yeah.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Hanging out.
My question is, what's it like come Animate Miami 2015?
I'm having a great time thus far. This is our first day. Just got in last night. I just love Miami, you guys. It is a fun town. Love coming here.
It's, and you live in L.A., right?
I do live in L.A. Miami, in a certain way, it's like L.A. meets the Caribbean to me, and I think that's a really cool vibe.
Yeah. Are there more crazy people here or in Los Angeles?
I haven't been to all the neighborhoods here, so I couldn't comment, but there are a lot of crazy people in L.A., yeah. Especially
this
the actors, because you have to be crazy to want to be an actor.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Zach.
Thank you.
I'm here again. Sorry.
That's
but
okay.
I have a question. So, I've heard that you guys like a lot of YouTube shows. So, I was listening to a recent podcast. Do you know the YouTuber named Pan Pizza, by any chance?
I do not.
Okay. Look him up, because, I was asking that because he mentioned you on the podcast because he was like, Like, he's like an animation reviewer.
Okay.
He's fairly popular in the animation community. And he was mentioning you. And he was like, you talked about the Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged one.
Yeah, Little Karibo is my favorite.
So, like,
Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged is my jam.
He was like so jealous of that because he really wants to be like part like so, he wants somebody to notice him, and I just found that I just like was like, oh god, I need to tell one of the
Pan Pizza.
Got look him up and maybe talk to him because like
cool.
he needs
recognition.
Love. He has an obsession with goth girls and he needs help and he needs an animation.
He needs guidance.
He has like 200,000 subscribers, so he's sort of
popular. Oh, so he's doing pretty good for himself.
Yeah, he is, but he...
You can always do better.
I just thought of him, and I was like, I gotta do this for Pan. I gotta do it for him.
Do it for Pan, man.
He's going through rehab of goth girls. So, look
him
up.
We actually have to move you along, because we want to get to our last couple. Oh, girls who just ran up online, I don't know if we'll have time, but... Sir, you again, our little friend. What's up?
What's your favorite Earth gem?
My favorite Earth gem? Oh, I don't know. You have a pick?
I think earlier I said Garnet, and I'm sticking to that.
If we're counting the crystal gems as Earth gems, I have a hard time playing favorites because I'm so close with the actors.
Yeah.
I guess I'll just roll a dice. Say Garnet for this time. It changes by the week.
Okay.
All right, thanks. And we're actually going to make you the last question. Sorry,
wow.
Guys. We got to wrap it up. Go ahead. You're our finale.
Oh, God. First off, happy birthday, of course.
Thank you.
I was wondering if... How you doing?
Hey.
I was wondering if you think that Steven will ever get control over most of his powers. Like transformation, if he would ever be able to do that. And I was wondering also if, do you think Connie would be like in battles if, you know, leading up to bigger stuff? Do you think that Steven would be like, no, you know, don't go, I don't want you to get hurt, or Connie's just gonna be like, hey, I can protect you?
As far as the powers go, Steven can transform, so he's selling cat fingers.
I mean, more than that, like
actually do it correctly. I think that he'll get a handle on his powers one day as he grows. I mean, on the pace that he's going, he's doing pretty well for himself. As far as his attitude towards Connie goes, I think he knows that she's capable and stands up for her. I mean, in Nightmare Hospital, we saw that her conflict with her mother. He didn't really bat an eye at her bashing monsters' heads in, or arms for heads. So yeah, I don't think he would have as much of a problem with it. To a certain degree, once it gets too perilous, he might feel protective, but...
Yeah, I can't give any spoilers away as far as exactly what is going to happen with Connie's character, but one of my favorite things about playing Connie is seeing, even with going from Bubble Buddies up to Nightmare Hospital, is the amount of growth that she's had. She's gone from being very timid and insecure to actually really coming out of her shell with Steven and really showing what her passions are and how brave she really is.
Thank you so much.
All right, well, thank you. And thank you to everyone who came to this panel today. How about a big round of applause for Zach Callison and Grace Rolek and Steven Universe.
Big round of applause for yourselves, guys. Thanks for coming out.
Yeah, thanks for coming out.